He's the Lord, if you will, of creation. He's the Lord of recreation. But if he's the Lord of creation, if he's the Lord of what he can recreate, then he's also the Lord tonight of what you have left. He's the Lord of your good. He's the Lord of your bad. If he's the Lord in your health, he's the Lord in your sickness. If he's the Lord in your trouble, he's the Lord in your triumph. If he's the Lord in your abundance, he's the Lord in whatever it is you have left tonight. We serve a God who is the God of the underdog. He is able to take the one who didn't seem like they should have been on top and put them on top. From the very beginning of time, he took Abel, who was the second son, but made him the son of favor. He took Abram, who was in the land of Chaldees, and called him and made him a son of the covenant of promise, a father to many nations. He took Jacob, who was a liar and a supplanter, and made him a father to the 12 tribes of Israel. He took Joseph, who was one of the youngest of his brothers, and made him a prince in Egypt. I said we serve the God of an underdog. We serve the God that's able to take David, the seventh son of Jesse, and make him king of the nation of Israel. Why? Because he could see what they had inside. Men look on the outward appearance, but tonight the Lord is not looking on what's on the outside. He's looking at the potential of what's on the inside. What could he do with what little praise that you might have left? What little prayer you might have left, what little promise you might have left in the hands of God, he can do great and mighty things tonight. I don't know about your house, but we had Thanksgiving dinner at my house this week, and it was good. It was real good. Mom made some good sweet potato casserole. My wife made a great seven-layer salad. I'm happy. Homemade dressing, Brother Stubbs. But a few Thanksgivings ago, I remember we'd eaten our Thanksgiving dinner. The next day, it came a snow. And my mother-in-law is the master of a leftover. She went in that kitchen. She took what remnants, what scraps there was, and she made the most, she called it mess around, but it was the most God-blessed noodles and beef and cabbage and potatoes. And it didn't look good, but it tasted wonderful. And I've seen her do it other times. People would show up at the house. We'd have already eaten dinner. And somebody would show up. And they'd say, well, when y'all eating? Well, excuse me. And she'd go get the leftovers and make them what would have been scraps to anybody else. She made them a gourmet feast. Can I tell you tonight that God is a master of the leftovers? He can take whatever you've brought in this place tonight, whatever scrap is you feel like is left of your life, and make a beautiful full-course meal out of it. Make something that you can feast on. Make a way where there seemed to be no way. We serve a God of an underdog. We also serve a God of a turnaround. Last night, I was carnal. I like football. And I don't care if I get to watch any other football game, Brother Stubbs. I'm going to watch the Iron Bowl. It's Alabama versus Auburn. It's rivalry weekend. We won our game soundly, 52-17. Roll Tide. But later, or 51, I'm sorry. Later, 21, that's right. I'm so sorry. Later, I'm sitting in my recliner, and I'm debating on whether it's time to go to sleep or not. And my brother-in-law was out the house. He said, you got to turn this game on. I said, well, what game is it? He said, it's LSU versus Texas A&M. So I cut it on. They were going into overtime. LSU intercepts the ball from A&M. They think they've won the game. So much so, they pour Gatorade on the coach's head. They begin to celebrate. They think the game is over. And the ref steps in and says, no. We need to review the play. And upon review, the quarterback had dropped the ball. And when he dropped the ball, he went down on a knee to pick it up, which means the ball is dead. So anything from that point forward, the play was over. So they call it back. A&M gets the replay. A&M ends up scoring. Seven overtimes later, each team scored at least 72 points, one of the highest scoring football games in my life, maybe one of the longest, too. A&M wins the game. And you say, Brother Brian, you cheese, slit off your cracker. Why have you told me that? I've told you that for this reason. A&M thought they had lost. Their enemy was celebrating. But one who has a higher power came in and began to turn the situation and give them another chance. Can I tell you, in your life, your enemies may be rejoicing. It may look like it's over. It may look like trouble's all around you. But there's a higher power tonight who's the ruler of all things, who is the Lord of your life, who will step in and make a turnaround and turn away where there seemed to be no way. There are three places where Jesus does his best work. Three places. When we read the miracle of the feeding of the multitude, the feeding of the 5,000, is the only miracle recorded in all four Gospels of the New Testament. But when we read Matthew's account, he says this, he says, and when evening was come, the disciples came to him and said, the time has passed, and it is a dry place. Now, I'm paraphrasing a little bit. But let us send them away, send them to another village where they could find food. Did you catch that? Three places. Nighttime, dry times, and when there seems to be no time. They said, Jesus, it's evening time. And this is a dry place. And we've got no food. How are you going to feed these people? Jesus didn't flinch. Jesus didn't move. Jesus looked at him and said, well, what you got? And a little boy brings five loaves and two fishes. Now, my whole life, you may have studied it differently. You may have understood it differently. But for some reason, Brother Stubbs, my whole life I've read these passages, and I thought this was about lunchtime, about middle of the day. This little boy had brought his lunch sack and handed it to Jesus. But it said it was evening time. To me, implies the end of the day. Nighttime is coming. Can I tell somebody tonight, weeping may endure for the night, but joy is going to come in the morning. So nighttime is coming. Now, if I'm a little boy, and I've been here all day listening to Jesus, I've probably already dipped into my lunch. Y'all, Emery went to Mom and Dad's house last weekend. Dad came in the next morning. He said, son, I want you to know, you live on. I said, how's that? He said, I came in the living room, and Emery was set up in a recliner, eating sour cream potato chips and drinking a Dr. Pepper. Woo, that's my girl. Nighttime is the right time to eat a snack. Anyways, seriously though, this little boy had probably already dipped into his meal. So my whole life here, I thought, he gave Jesus a whole meal, and from a whole meal, Jesus fed the multitudes and had some left. But no, no, no. I submit to you, maybe he gave Jesus his leftovers, and from his leftovers, Jesus was able to feed the 5,000 and still have more leftovers. The question tonight is, what do you have left that you could give Jesus? What do you have left in your heart that in the hands of God, it's a leftover to you, but it's a complete meal to someone in need. It's a complete meal in the house of God. What could God do with what you have left tonight, Brother David? What can he do with what you have left tonight, Brother Alford? He's the God of your leftover. What looks like a scrap to you in the hands of God is a complete gourmet meal for someone else. He is able to take it and feed the 5,000. Now unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all you can ask or think, according to what? The power that worketh in you. So, lest you're deceived tonight, I'm not saying that we're anything special. I'm saying me, what I have left, plus the power of God, is able to do great and mighty things. But Jesus can't do anything tonight if you refuse to give him what you have left. Zero plus zero is still zero. God would add and multiply. God would bless, but who would let him? Jesus told the disciples this. He said, wait, go and rest on high till you be endued with power What power? And the power of another comforter. The power of the Holy Ghost. The Greek word there, parakletos, means another one that would come along beside and help. Another form that Jesus would give them power to help them. Now, you may never have been in trouble. You may never have needed someone to come alongside you and give you legal advice and bail you out of a situation. But there's been times I could have used that. Can I tell you tonight, the Holy Ghost can be a paralegal to somebody that needs its help. It could be a paramedic to somebody that's sick. It can be whatever you need it to be to anybody that needs it tonight. It doesn't matter what you have left. It doesn't matter how beat down, cast down, defeated you think you are. We serve a God tonight who is able to take whatever you'll give him and make something beautiful. If you believe that tonight, give the Lord praise.
Y'all look nervous. Sister Carmen, come out. Who thinks Sister Carmen should come out of the closet? Come on. She's going to help me preach a little bit. She's like putting jam on bread. Bread's good, but you put jam. Come on, get a microphone. Come on, get a microphone. Get off Facebook and get a microphone. Get a microphone. I want you to interpret for me out here. Green, Christian. Amen. Give God a hand clap of praise. You're on. He's got to turn you on back there. Try it again, Carmen. Cut her up. It's on. Try it again. Let's get a different microphone because I'm not preaching by myself. We're trying gray now, Christian. Try gray.
Estamos bien?
Can you hear? Cut her up a little bit. Try.
Aplaudan a Dios.
Yeah. So cut her down just a hair. She can't be louder than me. I'll let you be seated since you've already heard one sermon tonight.
La vamos a permitir que se sientan.
I'm going to ask you.
Le voy a preguntar.
I'm going to be pastor for just a minute.
Voy a ser pastor por un momentito.
We love your children.
Nosotros amamos a sus niños.
Whether they're big or little.
Sean pequeños o grandes.
We're glad they're in the house of the Lord.
Me da mucho gusto que estén aquí en la casa de Dios.
But you make sure.
Pero asegúrese.
They're in the right mindset.
Que estén en la mente correcta.
To be in the sanctuary.
Que estén aquí en el santuario.
We're not playing games.
No estamos jugando juegos.
Let's have respect for the word of the Lord.
Tenemos que tener respeto para la palabra de Dios.
Let's play games at home.
Juguemos juegos en la casa.
This is not just for you.
Esto no es solamente para usted.
You ask my children.
Tú le puedes preguntar a mis niños.
We play games in church.
Nosotros jugamos juegos en la casa de Dios.
You ask my grandchildren.
Pregúntele a mis nietos.
I've left the pulpit and spanked my granddaughter before.
Yo puedo dejar aquí y ir a darle una nalgadita a la niña.
If I spank them.
Si yo le doy una nalgadita a la niña.
I spank you too.
Le doy su nalgadita también.
Who loves pastor?
¿Quién ama al pastor?
It's important.
Es importante.
I'm going to, the book of Genesis.
El libro de Génesis.
In the beginning.
Al principio.
God created heaven and earth.
Dios creó la tierra y los cielos.
And the earth was without form.
Y la tierra no tenía forma.
And void.
Estaba así, sin forma.
And darkness was upon the face of the deep.
Y la oscuridad estaba sobre la tierra.
And the Spirit of God moved.
Y el Espíritu de Dios se movía.
Upon the face of the waters.
Hacia arriba de las aguas.
And God said.
Y dijo Dios.
Let there be light.
Que haya luz.
And there was light.
Y se dio la luz.
I'm glad that God still moves.
Me da mucho gusto que Dios aún se mueve.
He moved over the midst of nothing.
Él se mueve encima de algo que no tiene significado.
But I'm glad he still speaks.
Pero me da mucho gusto que aún hable.
He don't just move.
No solamente se mueve.
He still speaks.
Él habla.
He don't just let the earth go through its motions.
Él no solamente deja la tierra que vaya con la movimiento, la emoción.
But he sees something that could be more.
Pero él ve que puede ser más.
He sees it as it is.
Él lo ve como lo es.
But he says it can be more.
Pero él dice es más.
The first thing it needed was light.
Lo primero que él necesitaba era la luz.
Brother Blankenship.
Brother Blankenship.
With the scientific mind that you have.
En la mente científica que usted tiene.
Would you confirm?
Usted puede confirmar.
It is impossible to have life.
Es imposible tener.
Without light.
Sin la luz.
You can't have life.
Usted no puede tener vida.
Without light.
Sin la luz.
My Sunday school class this morning.
La clase de la mañana.
Heard a little of this.
Él escuchó un poco de esto.
The scientist of Europe in the 1800s.
El científico de Europa en el año 18.
They thought that there was new life, different life, at the deepest parts of the ocean.
Ellos pensaban que había una luz diferente al final del océano.
But it took to the 1920s.
Pero llevó hasta el.
You're doing good.
1919.
Yeah. Before they had the ability to go 3 and 4 miles deep.
Que tenía la habilidad de llegar hasta 2 y 3 millas hacia abajo.
There's new fishes.
Había nuevos pescados.
New plant life.
Nuevas plantas.
We just got to get there.
Nosotros ellos tenían que llegar ahí.
But after great research.
Pero a través de un recursos, buenos recursos.
They said there's no new life.
Dijo, no hay una nueva luz.
No new fishes.
No hay nuevos pescados.
No new plants.
No hay nuevas plantas.
But they were variations.
Pero hay deviaciones.
Of existing animals and plants.
Pero había animales vivientes.
They morphed themselves.
Ellos se multiplican solo.
That's a good word. They morphed themselves.
Se multiplican solos.
Into something different.
Si hay algo diferente.
Same origin.
What was that?
Same origin. They were the same from the beginning.
Yeah, eran los mismos desde el principio.
But they changed.
Pero cambiaron.
If you see the fishes, they got these big eyes.
Si usted ve los pescados, tienen tamaños ojotes.
To catch a glimpse of what little light may go to the darkness of the depth of the sea.
Que ven todo a pesar de los ojitos pequeños, ellos lo ven.
A normal mouth would be elongated or made big.
Una boca se hace bien grande.
To catch what little life they may be able to catch of another fish
y con
or
los
plant.
Ojos pequeños lo puede agarrar a otros pescados.
They really look deformed.
Se ven como deformados.
Because they had adapted to a place they were not created to be.
Porque habían adaptado un lugar que no había sido creado para
ellos. In the book of Romans.
En el libro de Romanos.
Paul says.
Pablo dijo.
That there are men that when they knew God.
Que habían hombres que cuando conocieron a Dios.
They glorified him not as God.
No lo glorificaron como Dios.
And their hearts were darkened.
Y el corazón estaba oscuro.
They became something.
Y ellos se convirtieron en algo.
That God had never intended for them to be.
Que ellos se convirtieron en algo que Dios nunca lo intentó, nunca quiso que se convirtieran en lo que se convirtieron.
Boy, that's awesome. And their foolish hearts were darkened.
El corazón estaba oscuro.
In the absence.
En la ausencia.
Of the presence.
O de la presencia.
Of life.
De la luz.
They became malformed.
Se convirtieron en deformados.
Deformed.
Deformados.
Excelente. In their deformity.
En la deformación.
Their features became exaggerated.
La figura se exageró.
Disfigured.
Se desfiguraron.
Can I say this for your understanding tonight?
Que le pueda decir esto para que usted me entienda.
After the research of the deep waters.
Después de la investigación de las aguas bien profundas.
Scientists had a revelation.
Los científicos tuvieron una revelación.
That the life that's in the water.
Que la luz estaba en el agua.
Was created.
Era creada.
In the shallows.
En la sombra.
Where there was plenty of light.
Donde había suficiente luz.
Because God knows.
Porque Dios sabe.
For us to have life.
Para que nosotros tengamos luz.
There's got to be light.
Tiene que haber una luz.
And if we allow our hearts.
Y si nosotros permitimos
to be darkened in sin. We'll become a deformity.
Si lo dejamos que nuestros corazones estén en la oscuridad, nos vamos a deformar.
You look in that passage in Romans.
Mire ese pasaje en Romanos.
He turned them over to a reprobate's mind.
se convirtieron en, no sé.
Anybody got help? Call a friend. Call a lifeline.
Neely.
No help? What's the word?
What is la palabra?
Reprobate.
Reprobación. I got it, Pastor.
Excellent. Comprende? Comprende?
Seguimos?
He's saying,
dijo,
if you want to believe that a man can love a man,
si usted cree que Dios, que el hombre puede robar al hombre,
that wasn't created in the light.
Eso no fue creado en la luz.
That was created in the darkness.
Eso fue creado en la
it's
oscuridad.
A deformity.
Es deformación.
It's not what God intended.
Eso fue, eso no es lo que Dios, intentó.
Now let me say, God says in Revelation,
Dios dice en revelación,
the first words that he speaks,
la primera palabra que él habla,
said, let there be light.
Deja que haga luz.
I had a teacher in the third grade,
yo tuve una maestra en el tercer grado,
that taught us how to do pottery,
que nos enseñó cómo crear una base de barro.
What boy doesn't like to get his hands dirty?
¿A qué niño no le gustaría ensuciarse sus manos con el barro?
And she had a little dog she had made.
¿Y ella tenía una pequeña muñeca?
It was a simple little dog she had made out of pottery.
Era una sencilla muñeca.
She said, y'all gonna make the same thing I made.
¿Y van a crear ustedes lo mismo que yo creé?
Brother Brian, I made a mistake.
Hermano Brian, yo hice un error.
That looks easy.
¿Eso se ve sencillo?
She said, you think it's easy?
The teacher dijo, ¿tú crees que esto está sencillo?
My mouth's been getting me in trouble for years.
La boca siempre me ha llevado a problemas.
She had a scarf in her desk.
Tenía, what did she have?
A scarf.
Oh, yes, una bufanda.
And she coiled it up.
Y le dio vuelta, le enrolló.
She tied it around my eyes.
Y le tapó los ojos.
Everybody else gets to make the dog.
Todos van a crear la muñeca.
But since Mr. Sadler,
pero Mr. Sadler
says it's easy,
dice que es fácil,
I'm sure he can do it with his eyes closed.
Estoy segura que lo puede crear con los ojos tapados.
In the dark.
En la oscuridad.
I said it ain't too hard.
Esto no es, y yo dije, esto no es difícil.
Sister Josephine,
hermana Josefina,
I took one last peep under that blinder and got a good image in my mind of that loco perro. And I went to work.
Y empecé a trabajar.
When I got done, I laid it on my desk.
Cuando terminé, ahí la dejé en el escritorio.
Easy.
Fácil.
The teacher saw that I considered myself finished, and she came and said, do you want to see your creation?
La maestra se dio cuenta que yo ya había terminado y me dice, ¿tú quieres ver la creación?
She took the veil off my eyes.
Y removió la bufanda de mis ojos.
Brother Oscar.
El hermano Oscar.
With my eyes closed in utter darkness.
Con los ojos cerrados en la oscuridad.
I said, man, it must look good.
Esto lo más seguro se ve muy bien.
I had a three-legged perro.
Tenía un perrito con tres piernitas, con tres patitas.
It was a deformed, mangly mutt.
Era un deforme en el barro.
I don't know if you get what I'm preaching today. And there are people that
personas,
they think their life is well put together and they got it going on.
Y lo saben todos.
In darkness it looks pretty good.
En la oscuridad se ve todo bien.
That's why nightclubs are in the dark.
Por eso es que los nightclubs están en la oscuridad.
Because she's pretty good looking.
Porque ella se ve muy bonita.
In the darkness.
En la oscuridad.
But when some light is shed on,
pero cuando la luz llega,
how am I doing?
Muy bien.
Sí, gracias. Just as God spoke, let there be light.
Así como Dios habló y dijo que se haga la luz.
John's gospel says, in the beginning.
En el libro de Juan dice, al principio.
Does that sound familiar to you?
Está muy familiarizado con
esto. In the beginning was the word.
Al principio era la palabra.
And the word was with God.
Y la palabra estaba con Dios.
And the word was God.
Y la palabra era Dios.
The same in the beginning with God.
Lo mismo desde el principio con Dios.
All things were made by him.
Todas las cosas son hechas por él.
Without him was nothing made. I'm going somewhere.
Sin él nada se hubiera hecho. Woo.
There was a man sent from God.
Había un hombre enviado por Dios.
Whose name was John.
Y su nombre es Juan.
The same came for a witness.
Él vino para ser testigo.
To bear witness of the light.
Testigo de la luz.
And all men through him might believe.
Y todos los hombres para que creyeran a través de él.
He was not the light.
Él no era la luz.
But was sent to bear witness of the light.
Pero él lo enviaron para que fuera testigo de la luz.
That was the true light.
Era la verdadera luz.
Which lighteth every man.
La luz en cada hombre.
That cometh into the world.
Que viene a través de la palabra.
Here's what I said all that to say this.
Dije todo eso para terminar con esto.
God spoke, let there be light.
Dios habló y dijo que la luz, que se haga la luz.
So he could have a creation.
De esa manera podía tener una creación.
Jesus came as the light.
Jesús llegó y en la luz.
To have a recreation.
Para tener recreación.
I'm telling you in the Old Testament.
Te estoy diciendo en el Testamento viejo.
God put light that man could see.
La luz. Dios puso la luz en el hombre para que concibiera.
But man's heart was hardened.
Pero el corazón de los hombres estaba endurecido.
And sin dominated.
Y el pecado dominaba.
The imagination was darkened continually.
La imaginación estaba oscuro.
God said, I spoke, said, let there be light.
Y Dios dijo, yo hablé y que se haga la luz.
And it covered the face of the earth.
Y que cubra la tierra.
But God came as light.
Pero Dios vino como la luz.
To recreate.
Para recrear.
That where the sun, S-U-N, could not go.
Cuando el sol.
The S-O-N, sun, could go.
El sol llegó.
That he could come in our hearts.
Que pueda llegar a nuestros corazones.
I don't know if you're getting it tonight,
no sé,
but
si
I'm telling you.
Esta noche,
the light of God's word can make
trabaja.
A recreation.
Él recreó.
Where anything's possible.
Todas las cosas son posibles.
Come on, stand to your feet.
Párese, por favor.
I'm preaching to somebody tonight.
Estoy predicando a alguien esta noche.
God is speaking to you.
Dios está hablando contigo.
Brother Brian said God will take your leftovers.
Dijo que él va a tomar lo que ha sobrado.
I'm speaking to you on the beef part of the album.
Estoy hablando contigo.
Come out of the darkness.
Salte de la oscuridad.
Into his marvelous light.
Hacia la luz maravillosa.
You got it all covered up.
Tú lo tienes todo cubierto.
You got a pretty good life.
Puede tener una buena sonrisa.
You keep telling everybody what a good life you have.
Tú le dices a todo mundo qué tan bonita es la risa.
But if you haven't let the light.
Pero si usted dejara que la luz.
Touch your heart.
Toque su corazón.
You'll be like my three-legged dog.
Lo va a ver como mi perrito con tres piernitas.
Telling everybody what a perfect life you got.
Dígale a todo mundo cuál tan perfecta vida tiene.
But your foolish heart is darkened.
Pero tu corazón es el que está en oscuridad.
Jesus is not going to kick in the door to your heart.
Dios no va a patear la puerta de tu corazón.
I don't know where Jesus took jiu-jitsu.
Yo no sé dónde Jesús agarró la clase de karate.
No. If you want to stay in darkness,
si usted quiere estar en la oscuridad,
and want to believe a lie,
y quiere creer la mentira,
and live in darkness,
vivir en oscuridad,
and be deformed,
y ser deformado,
and your life be diminished,
y su vida ser
God will let you do it.
Yeah, Dios lo dejará.
But if you want to come out of darkness,
pero si usted quiere salir de la oscuridad,
who's got problems?
¿Quién tiene problemas?
Who's got problems you can't solve?
Amen. ¿Quién tiene problemas que no lo puede solucionar?
I believe the Lord is speaking.
Yo creo que Dios está hablando.
Old Testament.
El Testamento viejo.
Logos.
Logos.
A word to think about from God. But today we have the Rhema.
Pero hoy tenemos la Rhema.
That's a now word.
Es una palabra.
God's got a now word for some of us.
Tiene una palabra para alguno de nosotros.
If you will just allow yourself,
si usted le permite a su persona,
to be honest with yourself,
ser honesto,
because God already knows,
porque Dios ya lo sabe.
Would you just step out tonight?
Por favor.
You're not asking for prayer. You're getting down to business. You're saying, God, here I am.
No
three-legged
dog. En sus rodillas y oren y digan, aquí estoy, Señor.
I need some light shed on my situation.
Yo necesito una luz que alumbre.
I need some
problemas.
Life to come where there's only been death. I need joy to come where there's only been despair.
El gozo que llegue.
I need peace to come.
Necesito paz.
Where only chaos had been.
Donde tantos problemas han habido.
Would you come and pray tonight?
Por favor, venga a orar.